our mucker's nice. I mean, we have.
Structure.
I get that. But did you see the whole trash can thing on the sideline of Tennessee?
I did not.
Because when you look at Tennessee's defensive numbers, number one against the pass, but last in the SEC against the rush. Kind of weird, of course, Georgia Tech has something to do with that. But does that change your offensive philosophy?
No, we need to find ways that we feel like we can move the ball. Certainly, I think that statistics can be very skewed when you play a team like Georgia Tech, and as effective as Paul Johnson and those guys are running the football, and certainly your rushing stats are not going to be what you want when you play a team like that. So it's a total different mindset and attack of what we do, and so we need to stay balanced in the game. I know that, and early on in the week we feel good about where we are.
Do you run into a lot of Tennessee does with multiple tight ends, and how tough is that kind of going to do that, sort of having two of those guys out there and sort of the versatility that you use for those?
Well, I think there's some similarities between what they do and what we do as far as, Wolf's been there, 6-8 years. He's been there a long time, it seems like. He's had a brother come. But they create some blocking service issues. It's a four-man blocking service at times. Some movement as far as leveraging formations when they're in two tight end set, and they're in a one tight end set a lot as well. So I think there's a lot of similarities and carryover for our defensive players as opposed to what last week there was not.
Well, you talk about the defensive line. How have you seen DJ Wanham play, SEC defensive line player of the week? How impressed have you been with his play, and how have you seen maybe him take on more of a role, more of a leadership role with Bryson's absence?
Well, there's no doubt that DJ has played extremely well this year. He's just a steady hand. You're going to get really good production out of him. He has really done a nice job of improving his one-on-one pass rush. He's had some really nice rushes. He missed some opportunities the other night. He's right there a couple of times to show you how hard it is to sack a quarterback. I've been so proud of how he's played and as a true freshman last year, and how he has continued to evolve. It really challenged him about, number one, getting stronger in the weight room, and really he is extremely bright. He's extremely intelligent. He really understands the game. He's a guy you can tell something to him one time and he gets it. It's done. And I've telling him over and over again, he's not a rep guy. I mean, the game comes very easy to him. He's going to play for a long time.
Well, you've watched and coached a lot of defense in the SEC in your career. Is the defensive effort that you guys put out, is that kind of still the bedrock way to turn and build a program here in this league, as opposed to maybe other leagues where you see 63-59 games?
I don't, I coached Texas in the Big 12, and I don't think it's any difference whether you're in the SEC or what league you're in. You start with effort, and you hone each position down fundamentally to what you need to do to be successful. What are the basic fundamentals you're asking about position in any of the 11 spots, and then you got to be able to tackle, and then figure out, within your group schematically what can they do and what can they handle. I think that to me is anywhere I've been, and I've been a bunch of spots, I try to evaluate those things first as far as from a coach's standpoint, identifying your players, who can be your playmakers, who are your hot button guys that you need to get going in the rush, or you need to get in the coverage, and can we play man coverage? And those are all questions you ask yourself, but to me it all starts with effort. If you get them to play hard, I keep telling our football team, I think I haven't questioned our effort in any game. Keep playing hard, and you keep playing smart, and the ball bounces your way, good things are going to happen for you. And if you just will play hard and have some belief in each other, that's one thing this team is, they do play hard. You turn the tape on, and you see guys running the ball, you see guys on offense finishing, you see guys trying to play with physicality. Has it always been what we wanted? No. But I certainly, I don't question